Good morning, dear students. In last videos, we have seen about the synopsis related to haloalkanes and haloarenes. In this session, I am going to explain about the bits related to that haloalkanes and haloarenes. Now, we'll see the previous year KSET questions, whatever came from this chapter. So, see the first one. Here, they have given a reaction, okay, a series of reaction, and the reagent what they have taken is alkyl bromide. When it reacts with the continuation reaction of alcohol, aqueous KOH, KMnO4 and ammonia followed by bromination, what will be the D obtained in this reaction, that we want to find out. Okay. So, here the question is, what is D? So, first if you want to know D, first you want to know what is A, B, C formed in this reaction. Okay. Now, we will see the reaction. See here, they have given CH3CH2Br, ethyl bromide. When it reacts with first reagent, that is aqueous KOH. Okay, when aqueous KOH reacts with alkyl bromide, substitution will take place. So, nucleophilic substitution. In place of Br, OH substitutes and we will get CH3CH2OH. Alcohol is formed. Now, this alcohol again reacts with KMnO4, that means oxidation is taking place. When it is oxidized, alcohols are converted completely into acids. CH3COOH is formed. Now, the CH3COOH, this is A, okay, now this is B. Now, B react with ammonia. B reacts with ammonia. Now, plus NH3. Okay, we'll see the reaction. See, OH from here, one of the hydrogen from here eliminates as H2O. Now, what is left here? NH2. NH2 react with CO. Then we will get CH3, C double bond O, NH2. Amide is formed as C. Okay, now C react with bromine in alkali. Alkali in the sense NaOH or KOH. Okay, this is Hoffman bromamide degradation reaction. Whenever amide react with bromine in presence of alkali, so degradation takes place and converts into primary amine. The CO group is eliminated and we will get CH3NH2 as the final product, that is amine as formed, and this is the D. Now, what we got here, D, that is amine, CH3NH2. So, answer is fourth one. Now, see the next one. Reaction of methyl bromide with aqueous sodium hydroxide involves, okay, reaction of methyl bromide. So, with aqueous sodium hydroxide, methyl bromide is CH3Br. So, is this primary alkyl halide? Yes, this is primary alkyl halide. So, this primary alkyl halide is favors towards SN2 reaction, because primary alkyl halide is more reactive than secondary, than tertiary, towards SN2 mechanism. Okay, so this is primary alkyl halide favors towards SN2 mechanism. Now, see the next question. Which one of the following is not true for the hydrolysis of tertiary butyl bromide? Okay, with aqueous NaOH, tertiary butyl bromide. So, tertiary butyl bromide. This is tertiary butyl. Okay, if this tertiary carbon contains bromine, that is called tertiary butyl bromide. So, now this tertiary butyl bromide is a tertiary alkyl halide. So, tertiary alkyl halide is favorable towards SN1 reaction. Okay. So, see, which of the following is not true for the hydrolysis of tertiary butyl bromide with aqueous NaOH. Here they have given four options. See the first one. The intermediate formed is a carbocation. Yes, in SN1 reaction. It participates now in SN1 reaction. In SN1 reaction, carbocation is formed as an intermediate. That is correct one. Next one, reaction occurs through SN1 mechanism, obviously because it is a tertiary alkyl halide. Next one, rate of reaction doubles when the concentration of tertiary butyl bromide is doubled. okay, even this is correct, because rate of reaction is directly proportional to concentration of alkyl halide. Okay, once concentration of alkyl halide increases, rate of reaction also increases. So the third one is also correct. Next, see the fourth one. Rate of the reaction doubles when the concentration of alkali is doubles. Here we are not taking alkali, we are taking alkyl halide. So the fourth one is wrong statement according to the given reaction. Now see the next one. Which one of the following is not formed when a mixture of methyl bromide and bromobenzene is heated? Okay, here what we are taking, mixture of methyl bromide. Methyl bromide means CH3Br plus bromobenzene. Methyl bromide and bromobenzene. Bromobenzene means benzene ring with the which is with bromine. When these two reacts with sodium metal in presence of dry ether. Okay, when they those two react with sodium metal in presence of dry ether. Okay, here we will get three different types of products. For example, when these two undergo reaction, so bromine and this bromine reacts with sodium, eliminates as sodium bromide. Now alkyl group reacts with benzene, then we will get C6H5CH3, methyl benzene is formed. If suppose this is taken in excess, then 2 moles of methyl bromide reacts with sodium metal BrCH3. If it is 2 moles undergoing reaction, then bromine and sodium react together in presence of dry ether. Okay, this eliminates and CH3CH3 make a bond, converts into ethane. This is ethane. This is methyl benzene. What is another name of methyl benzene? That is toluene. Either toluene is formed or ethane is formed. If suppose when 2 moles of bromobenzene reacts, so that bromobenzene I am writing in this manner for our convenience. Okay. When such bromobenzene in 2 moles undergoes reaction, 2 moles of NaBr eliminates. Now 2 phenyl groups react together, converts into biphenyl or diphenyl. Okay, what are the products obtained here? Toluene, ethane and diphenyl. See here the question, which one of the following is not formed when a mixture of methyl bromide and bromobenzene is heated with sodium in presence of dry ether. Okay, so here what we got, we have got ethane. Ethane is there. Okay, diphenyl, diphenyl is there. Next one, toluene. Even toluene is there in the options. What is not formed? Propane is not formed. Okay, next one. Which one of the following is not true for SN1 reaction? Okay, which one of the following is not true for SN1 reaction? SN1 reaction can take place in polar solvents. Tertiary alkyl halides are more reactive to that. That is also correct. The rate of reaction does not depend on the molar concentration of nucleophile exactly, because it depends only on the concentration of alkyl halide. Next one, primary alkyl halides generally react through SN1 reaction. No. Only tertiary alkyl halides are more reactive and primary alkyl halides are least reactive. So this is the wrong statement related to the question. Now see the next question. An alkyl bromide reacts with sodium in ether to form 4,5 diethyl octane. The compound X is, some X reacts with sodium in presence of dry ether and it is giving this product. Now we want to find out that X. See here. Whenever alkyl bromide, that is taken as X, when X reacts with sodium metal in presence of ether, it is giving a product, that is 4,5 diethyl octane. Octane means containing 8 carbon atoms. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Give the numbering. So 1, 2, 3, 4. This is 4th carbon. At 4th carbon ethyl group C2H5. And 5th carbon also with C2H5 ethyl. So now balance with the hydrogens. okay, this is the compound whatever is formed. This is called 1, I'll write clearly here, CH3, CH2, CH2, CH, C2H5, CH2, CH2, CH3. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So it is octane. At 4th and 5th position, ethyl groups are present, so that it is 4 comma 5 diethyl octane. So this compound is obtained when we take X compound. What is that X we want to find out? Now this is an example of Wood's reaction. In Wood's reaction, when alkyl halide react with sodium metal in dry ether, we will get a compound of alkane. Okay, so see, when this compound exactly here bond is formed, okay, at this bond now chlorine is present. It is obtained by reacting CH3, CH2, CH2, CH, C2H5 bond. Here X you can take alkyl halide. Okay, this is the alkyl halide. So in place of halogen you can also take bromine, because in the given options they are giving bromine. Okay, when it reacts with sodium metal, so another mole Br, CH, C2H5, CH2, CH2, CH3. When these two moles react, what happens? Br and sodium together eliminates as 2NaBr. Now bond is made between these two carbon atoms of alkyl groups, and we will get this compound 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So this is the X group. What is its name? See, CH3, okay, in the fourth option, CH3, CH2 taken twice, two times it is present, CH. On CH, Br is present, C2H5 is present. C2H5 they have mentioned as CH2, CH3. So the answer is fourth one. Okay, now see the next one. An incorrect statement with respect to the SN1 and SN2 mechanisms of alkyl halide is. An incorrect statement with respect to the SN1 and SN2 mechanism of alkyl halides. Okay, see the first one. A strong nucleophile is an aprotic solvent, increases the rate of SN2 reaction. Yes, this is correct one. Next, competing reaction for SN2 reaction is rearrangement. There is no rearrangement reaction in SN2, because SN2 reaction is proceeds through the formation of transition state. So this is the wrong statement. SN1 reaction can be catalyzed by the some Lewis acids. Exactly. Next one, a weak nucleophile and protic solvent increases the rate or favors the SN1 reaction. Exactly, weak nucleophile can favors the SN1 reaction. So the wrong answer or incorrect statement is this one. There is no rearrangement reaction in SN2, because it proceeds through transition state formation. Okay, now see the next question. When bromocyclohexane react with magnesium in dry ether, what is A? That A, when undergoes proton or acid hydrolysis, what will be the B? The question is now, what is B? So see here, first take this compound, okay, cyclohexane bromide. This is not benzene, they didn't mention about double bond. When it reacts with magnesium in presence of ether, it converts into Grignard reagent, that is Mg, okay, Mg Br. This is called Grignard reagent. Okay, now Grignard reagent, this is A. When this A reacts with H2O in acidic medium, okay, so exactly here bond breaks. Mg gets positive charge, so OH minus of water is added here and hydrogen is added here. Then we will get here cyclohexane plus MgBrOH. So the B is this one. So are they given B? Yes, cyclohexane as the third option. Now see the next question. Reactivity of order of alkyl halides for dehydrohalogenation. What is meant by dehydrohalogenation? Removal of hydrogen and halogen is known as dehydrohalogenation. So what is order of reactivity? See, alkyl iodide is more reactive than alkyl bromide, which is more reactive than alkyl chloride than alkyl fluoride. So this is the order of reactivity of alkyl halides towards dehydrohalogenation. So among all, alkyl iodide is more reactive and alkyl fluoride is least reactive. So the answer is third one. Now see the next question. That is, the product formed during the following reaction are. Okay, so here they have given the reaction. We want to find out the product. See, this is hydroiodination, addition of hydrogen halide to the ether. So is this ether ROR form? Okay, see, tertiary butyl ether when react with hydrogen iodide, exactly bond breaks here. Okay, oxygen gets negative charge, carbon gets positive charge. Now iodine is added to oxygen, iodine is added to carbon, hydrogen is added to this O minus. Okay, then we will get CH3, and here iodine is added plus to the CH3O minus hydrogen is added, we will get CH3OH. Methanol is formed. So these are the two products when hydroiodic acid reacts with this ether containing tertiary butyl or tertiary carbon atom. So the answer is fourth one. Methyl alcohol and tertiary butyl iodide is formed as the final products. See the next question. Toluene reacts with halogen in presence of iron chloride, giving ortho and para halo compounds. The reaction. See, toluene is a compound containing methyl group on benzene ring. Now it is undergoing reaction with halogen in presence of iron chloride, FeCl3. Okay. At ortho position, hydrogen, para position, hydrogens are replaced by halogen. Then we will get ortho para substituted product, here X plus here another compound. Now para position is replaced by halogen. We know always hydrogen eliminates as H plus. Now this electrophile replaced by another electrophile, so it is said to be electrophilic substitution reaction. So the answer is fourth one. Now see the next question. Okay, in the following sequence of reaction, what is C? Okay, here we want to find out C. So first, what is undergoing reaction? Methyl bromide, CH3Br. When it reacts with KCN, we will get CH3CN, methyl cyanide. When it undergoes acidic hydrolysis, okay, then we will get acetaldehyde, CH3CHO. When this again, this is A, this is B. Okay, now B undergo reduction with lithium aluminium hydride. Then acetaldehyde converts into CH3CH2OH, that is alcohol. This is the C. Okay, so the answer C is alcohol. Which alcohol it is? Ethanol or ethyl alcohol. Ethanol or ethyl alcohol. So the answer is 2. Okay, see the next question. Which of the following statements is true in case of alkyl halides? Okay, which of the following statements are true in case of alkyl halides? They are polar in nature. Yes, they are polar in nature. So the first one is answer. They can form hydrogen bonds. No, they cannot form hydrogen bonds. Okay. Next, they are highly soluble in water. No, they are insoluble in water because they do not form hydrogen bonds. They undergo addition reaction. Always alkyl halides undergo only substitution reaction. No addition reaction. So the only first option is the correct one. Next, see the next question. See the 14th question. Which of the following compounds undergo haloform reaction? Necessary condition for haloform reaction is containing alpha methyl group. Okay, what is alpha methyl group? If a methyl group is present adjacent to the functional group, that is known as alpha methyl. So a compound containing alpha methyl group can easily participates in haloform reaction. Now this is functional group. Adjacent carbon is alpha and this is alpha. Due to containing alpha methyl groups, it can participate in haloform reaction. Okay. Now next one. See the 15th question. Tertiary alkyl halide is practically inert to substitution by SN2 mechanism. Because in tertiary alkyl halide, what is tertiary alkyl halide? A carbon containing halogen attached with three other carbon atoms. This is known as tertiary alkyl halide. This is bulky group, this is bulky group, this is bulky group, and even it is bulky group. So the incoming nucleophile cannot attack to this carbon atom. It hinders, which is hindering all the four bulky groups, hinders the attack of that nucleophile. That hindrance is known as steric hindrance. Okay, due to having steric hindrance, so tertiary alkyl halides inert towards the SN2 mechanism. Okay, primary alkyl halides. So tertiary alkyl halides are more reactive towards SN1, but primary alkyl halides are more reactive towards SN2. Here tertiary alkyl halide is inert due to steric hindrance. That is nothing but presence of presence of bulky groups on the carbon atom holding halogen. Okay, due to steric hindrance, it inert towards the SN2 mechanism. These are the few bits related to KSET previous year question papers.